Students, we are going to discuss angular acceleration in this lecture. So, angular acceleration is denoted by the letter alpha, which is the rate of change of angular velocity. Angular velocity is denoted by omega. So, alpha is omega by t, and when the omega value is very small, we put d over here. So, this is angular acceleration is given by d omega by dt, and its unit will be like this. Omega is denoted as radian per second, so acceleration will be denoted as radian per second square, just simple as that. Now, what will be the relation of angular velocity and the linear velocity? So to derive it, we are having it here. We know that theta is given by arc length and divided by radius. So in this equation, divide the both sides by t. So what is theta by t? Theta by t is angular velocity, and distance per unit time is given by velocity, linear velocity, and we have r here in the denominator. So what we are finally getting, v is equal to omega r. This expression gives the relation between the linear velocity and the angular velocity. Now, moving on in this series, we have find out v is equal to r omega. So what we'll do, we'll put the derivative over here, r omega. So dv by dt, and here r is constant, we are having d omega by dt. dv by dt is given by linear acceleration, r is constant, then d omega upon dt is angular acceleration. So this is the expression and the relation between linear acceleration and angular acceleration.